Hello and welcome to Quick Looks with the Casual Hour. I am Bobby. Joining me as always, the gamer on the go, Chase Kinnicky, who I am going to be taking into space. Chase, welcome to Next Space Rebels.
Bobby Bezos over here.
Bobby Bezos. Yes, we are going to be doing our absolute best to get there. I'm going to combine a few things that this is very personal today. And for you, you're going to hate one part of it, I think, a whole lot. Because you might love it, you might hate it. We're going to be checking out Next Space Rebels. But before I show you anything about it, I want you to blindly tell me everything you know about it.
Okay, let me see. I don't have any pages pulled up on this, so it really has to come off the top of my head. I'm going to say this released November, feeling like the 17th. Somebody's telling me the 17th. November 17th. If I had to guess the developer, studio. Am I warm?
You're getting hot. You're warming
up. Okay. Studio. Let's say Floris Kayak.
Okay.
How's that sound? How's that sound to you? I'm gonna just take a wild shot in the dark here and say that it's published by Humble Games, and this seems like to me a game that would be on PC, Xbox, and Nintendo Switch.
Gosh, you're so good at video games. How'd I do? You're very good at video games.
Damn. If you want, you know what? One more thing, little bonus. $20 game, but, and this is the piece de resistance. I'm gonna guess that it's currently 20% off, and it only costs $15.99 at the moment.
Damn.
How about that?
You're very good.
Damn. It's almost like I had that information fed to me before we started.
Hey, if you want more clairvoyance and video games, like and subscribe to our channel where we do both of those things twice a week here on YouTube, and we bring over all of our previous streams from twitch.tv/thecasualhour. Chase.
Now, Bobby, something that I cannot divine is what the fuck is Next Space Rebels? What is this game?
Chase, Next Space Rebels is art.
What FM is this?
Yes. Oh, I'm so excited to show this game to you. I love
it. Oh, no. Okay, this is giving me... So this is like somebody took Hypnospace Outlaw and said, what if we made it more real?
That is partially true. So there's a few things you're doing. You are an amateur rocket enthusiast.
And okay.
We're going to be working on growing our StarTube channel, which is going to allow us to get more subscribers, which is going to allow us to get more challenges as we go to build these rockets that we are trying to enjoy. So this game this game does some wild shit. It takes these ideas of, I just really like building rockets, or in my case, I just really like playing video games. But there's a whole segment that you can share with people that then becomes, well, am I doing it more for the aspect of the people, or am I doing it more because this is something I really care about?
And sure. So, what is it in documentaries, like the issue of the observed or something like that? When you're observed, you change your behavior.
Yep.
So like when you know that you're being watched on YouTube, do you change your content to fit your audience, or do you stay true to yourself? Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So as you can see, we currently have 930 subscribers. We're working our way up to silver. We need 70 more to do that. Excuse me. We've uploaded 14 videos so far. We've got quite a few views. We got a lot more likes and dislikes. I've unlocked these tags, and you can see that the tags have rarities to them. And so our tags are going to do...
Hot dog is a blue tag. That's one I'm looking at.
Like. Oh, yeah. So we got our rare. We've got our... we've got our uncommon, our rare. We even got our epic, and it tells you a little bit more, like, not used yet. This one is funny. But there's a character that you meet in the game, and there is some FMV in this. So... Rocket Girl.
Hey, I'm Lena Smalling, aka Rocket Girl, and this is where I work.
Okay, it's very... Somebody's watching an episode of Mythbusters.
Right? So, we've got this. You can go into full screen if you want to. Just like on YouTube.
Uh-huh.
And pause the
video. Okay, I'm liking this.
Yeah. So we'll go through the video really quick.
I mean, I hate this, but I like this as a whole.
Yes, yes, that's what I'm saying. So, like, we did a quick look for a game called Going Under that really did a lot with, like, tech culture, and you're like, I hate the way that they're talking because I have to deal with it. similar thing here. So you've got the whole YouTube interface or StarTube interface. Uh-huh. Down here, this is your messages. This is your inbox. And this is where a lot of the story of the game is taking place. And so Rocket Girl is like the top content creator when it comes to making rockets. And you have all these. And so as you get into it, you're going to have like dialogue choices that can unfold more options. And then
okay. She's chatting just with you. Like she's the biggest thing on the platform, and you've got an inside track to her.
Because I've garnered her attention through what I've been doing. So here's...
What have you been doing, Bobby?
The thing that makes this a big Bobby game. We get to build rockets.
Okay.
So over here, we've got our current challenges, and we need to make a heavy firework, or we can stay below 120. But over here is our structure. So let's just do a very basic rocket for the time being, which is going to be in our rocket kit. So I can grab this kit body and I drag this over and I can move this around and look at it at different angles. It's going to be pretty plain right now, but I'm going to need to put a base on it to hold it upright. So I'm going to just drop this here. Now I can take this and I can put it right there if I wanted to, but we're going to do this a bit more traditional and I'll put my cap on. So then we need to put some boosters, and I got a few different ones, but the standard booster is going to be this one, and we're going to go super traditional, Chase.
Looks like a rocket.
Looks like a rocket. So you can see that the complexity of what we just built is 12, and we can go all the way up to a level 35 complexity based off of what we've done. We've got our mass, we've got our thrust, and our stability is okay. I can copy or mirror exact parts. So I could have removed that one and then just select this and then hit mirror, drag that.
That's probably good. So you're not fucking things up.
Right.
Like if you put that booster way higher, that would probably make your stability worse, right?
It stays about the same for the time being.
Okay.
So let's build this rocket.
Sure. Oh, this is nice.
So we've got our rocket built.
Cool.
Yeah. And I can go back to the drawing board if I wanted to, but I want to launch this thing.
Sure.
So now we go to our, like, plot. And we're going to launch this rocket.
There it goes.
So then you can see your angle coming down, the speed.
About 56 meters.
Yep. Finish that.
But hey, you stayed under 120.
We did. Now, I hadn't selected that, so I can retry it. This gives me some breakout of it. But let's just upload that video. And
sure.
That was a symmetric, it was a rocket kit, and it had a little bit of a tail to it. Like, this is very basic. I can...
And you can change the title of this, too?
Yeah.
Okay.
Oops. So we'll just call this Quick Look, or QL. And I'll upload the video. And I doubt we get a lot from that. That's pretty...
A collab with Chase? I'm sure... That's... You know what? 14 new subs. That's my lucky number. So, you know, I'd say that I helped your channel out.
So some people will leave some comments. Again, not a crazy thing that we've done. You can see analytics for it. But these
How are these YouTube comments? Like, all those seem pretty positive.
I haven't had anything super toxic yet, but like one of the things we'll come back to the...
This is a fantasy game, is what you're saying.
Yes. So Sid is a young YouTube kid. Sid is a lot like a kid that we might know named Jude. And
he's got an anime avatar, so, you know, already getting there.
And you've got Salma down here who's been helping you out, kind of getting you started on building your channel. Sid gave you some toys, and it became real zany YouTube stuff, and you started to get a lot of kids commenting on it, and it became like, Salma's like, hey, you need to be careful. Like, I'm not telling you you can't do those things, but like, look at the views and the audience you're going for. It's like, that really the platform you want is to be like a kid idol. And so you've got people talking to you about like, are you doing this more again for views and analytics? Are you doing it because you enjoy the community that you're building and what you have going on there? So
now, Bobby, does the game allow you to just lean into that and say, yeah, I do want to be a kid YouTuber? Or is it following a story that you are trying to say? Are you following the story that they're laying out for you, or do you really have the freedom to say, I can be whatever YouTuber I want to be?
I stayed away from Sid because I was looking for some structure to add to my rocket. And after Salma told me that, I'm like, you know what? Maybe she's right. Maybe I don't want to do that. But then I started to feel like I had a really good conversation with Sid. And like, he really enjoyed that I incorporated one of his items into one of my videos. Like, it meant the world to him. Like, I don't want to just shun this kid who looks like, sure, maybe Sid wants to build rockets. And so I ended up talking to Sid, and I haven't heard back from Salma yet, but I'm going down it. Now, I did, however, cause some problems when I started talking to Rocket Girl, and I found out that there was somebody on here who happened to be her sister, which is Trash Wiz, and she did not like that her sister was giving me her information, so that caused me to have to get another path over here to the Bucket. And they are very funny because they want you to do virtual fishing to find junk, and they do this kind of like role play with how it goes.
Okay. Huh.
So you wait for a while, and then they're gonna let you know when they're ready to give you something, and this will be fun. This will be perfect for what we're doing.
Uh-huh.
And she did say, like, they'll make you earn it, is how she said it.
Yeah, like, do you have to reel it in? Do you have to get something else, or it just shows up?
Oh, there we go.
There it is.
Reel in.
Okay.
And what did we get? Ooh, we got a funnel. Awesome. So we're going to download that, and it'll say, hey, check back later on. So now, let's come back over here and see what we got. We can make this firework. Wait, I got that. This is saying to make a rocket go through a window. This is saying to build a toy block house. And this is a ridiculous rocket, which is we need to get to 1,000 meters. So I can set a goal for any of these. Let's just do the toy block house because you asked about the story.
Yeah, let's make Sid happy.
Let's make Sid happy. So, I'm going to do a frame here. And I think I could maybe make this the top of what I'm doing.
Sure.
And I could do this to be the bottom. So, we got a pretty big mass over here so far. I think I'm going to use my double booster might be perfect for this. So, this has gotten quite the thrust on it, and our mass is there. It has no stability whatsoever. So let me see if I can add in a little bit on
it. Yeah, I probably need some fins on it.
Yeah, so we've got some okay stability there. And you know what? Let's add a firework to this thing. What do you think?
Sure.
We'll put a little cherry bomb at the top, and we're going to build this. And there's our rocket.
Beautiful. Yep. Can't see anything going wrong with this.
Let's see what we do here. Whoa!
You know what? That went pretty bad. Went pretty far. It's still going up.
Arguably my best one yet.
Almost 700 meters. How about that?
So,
you know, with a better nose cone, I think you could break that 1,000.
That was huge. Holy shit. It did break apart, but I'm okay with that.
Do you need it to be saved?
No. So explosion, we'll use some rare ones here, and then
challenge
toys.
Okay. Yeah, I guess, yeah.
And I'll just leave this here, like, as a pretty generic description.
Sure.
We're going to upload this and see how did we do in our views. So not the best, but we did
get those subs. Sure.
Yeah. And let's see what happens with our comments here. Boom, boom, boom.
Sid. Oh, we do have a message, though.
Yeah. Oh, Sid says toys.
Toys.
I really love your rockets. Such a shame I don't have more toys to give you. It would be super cool to see rockets with lots of toys. Only if there was a way.
Oh, yeah, probably smart. Smart not to bilk the money out of your followers.
So this is where I think that's going to open up the path because...
Oh, because he's going to know more kids and then you're going to get into kid shit.
Just click on your toolbar and watch. OK, go see any comments if you can find from other kids and just ask them. Wow, thanks, I'll try that.
Okay, that's... okay, that's...
Yeah.
Weird. Yeah, why six?
Okay, so...
Sure, yep, that... You know what? Sounds about right.
And I won't go into it here with the hobby rocketeer, but he's the guy... So this is like a scientist, and he's like, hey... You're building your shit wrong, you dummy. He's like, you're not using science. And he's the one who gave me the recipe for this big-ass booster here. Like, it's a special
one. Okay. So, like, if you want to do some real rocketeering, here's how you get it done.
Yeah. Chase, I really like this game a whole lot. This has been fucking cool. It's on Game Pass. We're playing this on PC. As you mentioned, it's on Switch. It's on Xbox.
I wonder how it plays on a controller.
I would imagine that you would just be moving the cursor around, if I had to guess.
Which isn't always the most fun experience, but you know, it's doable.
Right.
Is this on Mac though? That's my real question.
I don't believe so.
Okay.
Don't believe so. But man,
let me see if I can pull that up real quick while you're still talking about it.
Yeah. So it keeps your videos on here, and then it will keep your community stuff going. As Sid was saying, if we go to the fireworks show, we come down here and we can start to look for, I think he was saying, oh, let me go back to one that has toys on it. That's what I need to do. So if I go back to one we just did, he said to come down here. Yeah, so we've got these
options.
It is on Mac.
It is on Mac and PC. Like we said at the top, it does have a 20% off. It's $15.99. I'm hovering over the buy button, Bobby.
I think that you should grab it. It's just a cool idea, man. And here would be those kids that we could reach out to get more toys for building.
Sure. Rabbit X Carrot sounds like a real winner.
Yeah, man. It's neat. I like the creativity. I really like how they show the build of what you're doing. I think that's really cool. And then the trial and error aspect of it. It's neat, man. I don't know a lot more about the developer.
It's like Kerbal Space Program, but much, much more fun and freeform, and also has this kind of interesting story stuff attached to it. I'm kind of digging what I'm seeing.
Yeah, absolutely. A surprise game that just hit Game Pass on day and date of launch. But if you want to see us build more dumb rockets and interact with our real YouTube community, like and subscribe, as we talked about, or tune into twitch.tv/casualhour. Monday, Wednesdays, and Fridays at 10:30 p.m. Central. Tuesdays and Thursday mornings, we post new quick looks here on youtube.com/casualhour. And if you're into just listening to podcasts, we post one of those every Friday at 9 a.m. Central. Chase, it's been a lot of fun, but I want to get off here and build some more rockets. Thank you for being here, and we'll chat with you all very, very soon. Take care.